Hello dear students, today we are going to start experiment that is direct operation of single acting and double acting electro-pneumatic system. Okay, so what is electro-pneumatic system? It consists of two things. One is electrical system, another is pneumatic cylinder. Okay, pneumatic means it is operated through air. Okay, hydraulic is operated through fluids, that is liquid or any particles, and pneumatics we are using in the air. Okay. So, as we are operating this pneumatic cylinder through air, so its main component is compressor, high pressure compressor. Okay. So, required device is first is compressor. Compressor is a device which is used to increase the pressure. Okay. So, this is the input. Input of this experiment. Second is air receiver or accumulator. It gets all the high pressure air inside a cylinder and then it will transfer to check valve. Check valve is a non-return valve through which if the air, high pressure air is passed from one port, then it will move to another port without any backflow. Next is directional valve, which is basically three types. Directional controller are basically three types. One is 2x2 directional control valve, 3x2 directional control valve, and 5x2 directional control valve. It means 5x2, 3x2 and 2x2. 5x2 means 5 stands for number of ports, 2 stands for number of position. Similarly for 3x2, 3 is number of ports, 2 is number of position. Similarly 2x2 is 2 is number of ports, 2 is number of position. What does it mean? It means 2x2 direct control valve. In 2x2 we can see one port. This is P for pressure and A for accumulator. Okay. So what will happen? This pressure, the pressure port, the air will input from the compressor will pass from this point, that is P, and this P will connect to A. And that is one port is P, another port is A. Okay. And this is a two position. How this is two position? P and A are connected to each other. This is the two position and two port. Similarly, this condition, this diagram refers to without air passage. Okay, when the air passage takes place, so what will happen? This is the diagram. P and air connect to each other. That is called after air passage. It means like this diagram shows the pressure will transmit to actuator properly. Similarly, for 3x2 direct control valve refers to pressure port. This is release port. Another actuator port, 3 port and 2 position. How this is 2 position? P and A, when P and A will link like this, so R is fixed. Similarly, when A and R are connected, then P is fixed. So this is a 2 position, P to A and A to R. Okay, that is 3 port and 2 position. Similarly, 5x2 direct control valve, it consists of 5 ports. Release port, 2 release port, 1 is pressure port, and in upper part there is 2 actuator ports. It is basically used in double acting cylinder. We will study in unit experiment. Okay, so next is last one is actuator, which is the most important thing in this experiment. That is, this is the output. Actuator is the output and compressor is the input. What is actuator? Actuator is a device. It basically convert the pressure energy into some motion, mechanical motion. That is called actuators. Next is actuation system in automation system. Basically in all over the world, basically in automation system we are using basically three things. One is sensors, valves and actuators. Okay. We will talk this thing in experiment. Next move to what is single acting cylinder and double acting cylinder. What is most important thing in your experiment? Single acting, what is single acting cylinder? What is double acting cylinder? In single acting cylinder, we are using a piston and a spring What will happen? This is the cylinder. In the cylinder, there is only one passage through which air will pass. That is air inlet passage. This air pressure will come in from the compressor. Okay. So what will happen? This air, after this air inlet inside the cylinder, the piston will push like this. This piston will move like this. This diagram shows without any pressure is going inside the cylinder. This is no air, no pressure or condition. After the air will pass inside the cylinder, what will happen? The piston moves like this. So here you can see, here the spring is in stable condition without any pressure. Here the spring is compressed like this. It means the air is already inside the cylinder. Okay, that is single acting cylinder. Only one air inlet. That is the key word. Keyword is only air, only one air inlet and only spring is used here. Similarly, in double acting cylinder, we are using similar thing, but here no spring is required. No spring required. Because in double acting cylinder, we are moving the cylinder from both sides, from left to right and right to left, through only air. Through only high pressure. So here there is two air inlet in one board. One is this is A1, you can see this is A1, this is A2. Okay, this is a two air inlet. Here this condition is without low pressure condition. When the air is inside the cylinder, the piston will move left to right. Piston will move from left to right. Can you see? A diagram, right? Piston moves from A this point to this point. Okay. So what will happen next? The air will make this air port will give another air pressure. So that piston will move like this. This is one side. So that the piston will reciprocate like this. In double acting cylinder, only through air without any spring. Okay. So this is the thing. Next is we will demonstrate your experiment in your lab. Here we can see that the reciprocating takes place in single acting and double acting. Both reciprocating will take place. Its main component is valves, directional control valve, which is already called 2x2, 3x2, and 5x2. This one. These are will be talked in your experiment. You can see. Okay, very easy to understand.